these big words are all about things that are very, very small.
Oh, like you?
Even smaller. You know how you can cut something into two pieces? And then you can cut those pieces into two pieces? And so on, and so on, and so on?
Like when you cut the cheese.
Ew, gross. Come on, Kromp, this is serious. So we're cutting something into smaller and smaller pieces. Well, at some point, you just can't cut anymore. The smallest piece of any kind of matter is called an atom.
Ooh, I want to see an atom. Let's have a show and tell.
Atoms are way, way too small to see. In fact, millions of atoms would fit on the head of a pin.
That's small. Wow, the atom is the smallest thing in the world.
Well.
What?
Well, inside of an atom, there are particles that are even smaller.
Ooh, so what are these teeny tiny particles inside the atom?
They're called protons, neutrons, and electrons.
Leonard, you're going too fast. Tell me about these teeny tiny particles one at a time.
Okay, let's start with protons. Protons have a positive charge.
Oh, so they're good guy particles.
Well, not really. Besides, they already have a name. Protons!
Goody two-shoe-tons! What's next?
Electrons have a negative charge.
Electrons are bad.
No, they're not bad. They just have the opposite charge from protons.
But isn't the opposite of something positive something bad?
It's more like the opposite sides of a magnet. You know how one side of a magnet is attracted to the other side? Well, positive charges are attracted to negative charges.
Is that where we get the saying opposites attract?
Yes, exactly. And things with the same charge push each other away. So electrons push away other electrons and protons push away other protons.
Okay, Froggy Woggy. Protons have a positive charge. Electrons have a negative charge. Next you're going to tell me neutrons don't have any charge at all.
That's right, Kromp. How'd you know that?
It's only logical. Neutron sounds like neutral. Neutral means you're not getting involved in a fight. You're staying out of it. Otherwise, the neutron would be fighting with the proton or the electron.
That's perfectly insightful of you there, Kromp. I didn't know you had it in you.
What do you mean? I'm a sensitive guy. I know things.
I'm sorry, Kromp. It's just that you're such a big, powerful monster. Sometimes I forget that you can be very thoughtful.
Okay, Froggy Wuggy, I accept your apology. But Froggy!
Yes, Kromp?
I thought we said we're going to learn things about electricity today.
Oh yeah! Electrons are very important when you think about electricity.
Oh really? Then they should call it electronicity.
Yeah, that's a good one, Kromp.
No, I'm serious. That should be the big word of the day. Electronicity!
No, Kromp. We already have a perfectly good word. Electricity!
Fine, but I still don't know what electrons have to do with electricity.
Well, there are different kinds of electricity. There's natural electricity like lightning. And there's static electricity that happens when you rub a balloon on your head.
This is fun.
But the kind of electricity most people know about is when electrons flow through wires. We call it electric current.
Oh, I've heard of electric current. That's what's in our outlets.
Yeah, it's how we turn on all our lights here at Socratica Kids.
I use electricity to run my hair dryer to make my fur pretty shiny, shiny, shiny.
I use electricity to make my toaster work in the morning. Yummy, yum.
So, in electric current, electrons flow. What's making them flow?
Well, you can make electrons flow by attracting them to something positively charged. Or you can make them run away from something negatively charged.
So there's electrons coming into my wall socket right now?
Yeah, but don't touch it! It's very dangerous to touch it!
Mommy Kromp says, not to touch wall sockets, but I want to see electrons, Leonard. Do you have one to show me?
Kromp, we just said we can't see atoms because they're too small.
Yeah, so?
The electrons are even smaller than an atom. It's part of an atom.
Yeah, so?
How can you see an electron if it's even smaller than an atom?
Oh, I get it.
Good.
Let's have a proton show and tell.
Kromp!
Leonard, ooh. Look. I'm in an elevator. Ding dong, where am I going? Choo choo, where am I going?
I can do that.
First floor, click my video. Where do you go?